Thank you, Ken Corley. The EU-UK Joint Committee meeting tomorrow, at which the implementation of the withdrawal agreement, including the critically important protocol on Ireland, Northern Ireland, will be considered, will be extremely important for people across all of this island, but most particularly for communities in my home region on both sides of the border. Given the backdrop of negative comments and analysis, unfortunately, we cannot be confident of progress. The findings in the recent report of the British think tank UK in a Changing Europe refer to the time being short, the gap between the two sides, and the economic impact and negative economic impact and political ramifications of a no deal. On the specific issue of the Northern Ireland Protocol, they say that there has been some progress by Britain in meeting its commitments to have the agreed arrangements up and running by the end of the year. But very worryingly, they also say that there is still a lot of detail to be clarified and that businesses, especially small businesses, will struggle to be ready. Local businesses in my constituency and across the border region are already struggling to survive. We have seen them do outstanding work in recent days and weeks to get back to work and exit the lockdown while protecting as many jobs and livelihoods as possible. We have seen local communities rally to support local retailers and businesses by shopping local and supporting local producers. But all this could be washed away by a hard December the 31st British crash out that drags Northern Ireland out against its will and without the necessary preparations by the Tory government in Westminster. We can see that the only hint of a plan that Prime Minister Johnston and his government have right now is to do nothing and hope that the EU's attitude to the UK might change when Germany takes the EU presidency. I do not think it is possible to overstate the scale of the damage that would follow a hard December 31st crash out. If the worst case scenario emerges, our region and communities will effectively be held hostage and used as leverage by a Tory party driven by Brexit madness. This would not be the action of a good neighbour. The government needs to urgently and immediately prepare for the worst. It needs to help businesses, as my colleague Deputy Haughey referred to, prepare for an economic shock and needs to work closely with our colleagues in Northern Ireland to ensure that we stand with businesses and communities on both sides of the border. Thank you, Ken Corley.